If you are getting ESPods FC25 starting error, then you are at the right place. We have got some easy ways that you can use to fix this issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Restart the EA app. When you are getting FC25 starting error, first of all, restart the EA app. From the EA app, click on the 3 horizontal line menu and select Exit. You can also click on the Help tab and select the Restart App option. Wait till the app restarts. To completely close the app, right-click on the Windows Search menu and select Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab. Right-click on all the processes related to the EA app and select the End Task option for each process. Then relaunch the app and check. Method 2. Restart your PC. You can also try fixing the game error by restarting the PC. Sometimes a simple restart can easily fix minor bugs and glitches that can be responsible for such issues. So restart your PC. After a fresh restart, relaunch the game and check. Method 3. Launch the game through the game installation folder. You can also try launching the game from its installation folder directly and not from Steam, and see if this can fix the issue. Open Steam and then head to Library. Right-click on the game. Go to Properties. Select Installed Files and then click on Browse. This should take you to the game installation folder. Try launching the game from here. If the error persists, move on to the next solution. Method 4. Enable offline mode. The next thing you can do is enable offline mode. To do this, open the EA app. Click on the hamburger menu app. Then select Go Offline. Click on the Yes, I am sure button to continue. Then go back again and click on Go Online from the menu. Restart the app and try to play the game again. Method 5. Run FC25 with administrative privileges. You can also right-click on the application you are using to launch the game. Next, select Show More Options. Open Properties. Go to the Compatibility tab. Check the box for Run this program as an administrator. Click on Apply and then OK to save the settings. Method 6. Repair, update or reinstall anti-cheat for FC25. Go to the installation location for FC25. Open the folder and then open the installation folder. Locate the EA anti-cheat folder and open it. Double-click on the EA anti-cheat installer. From here, select your game. Click on the repair option, then on OK. Next, go to the location where the game is installed and select the folder. Then click on Select Folder option. This will repair the anti-cheat. Next, click on Update so that you can make sure everything is up to date. You can also select the Uninstall option to uninstall the anti-cheat completely. Next, select the game from the drop-down menu and click on Install button to install the anti-cheat. It will also get reinstalled when you try to run the game next time. Method 7. Delete program data. Press Windows plus R to launch the run utility. Type %programdata% and hit Enter or click OK. Open the EA desktop folder. Then delete all the folders inside it. To do that, right-click on each folder. Select Show More Options and then select Delete. This should delete all the game saves but can fix the issue. Now relaunch the game and check. Method 8. Try a different compatibility mode. Another thing you can do is change the compatibility mode. To do that, open the game properties. Then go to the compatibility tab. Check the box for run this program in compatibility mode for the option. Select a Windows version and click on Apply and then on OK. Method 9. Verify the integrity of the game files. Missing or corrupted game files can also cause issues like this. So verify the game files. Here is how you can verify the integrity of the game files from Steam platform. Head to the Steam library, right-click on the game and open its properties. Go to the Installed Files tab and click on the Verify Integrity of the Game Files option. Wait till Steam verifies the game files and download the missing file or fix the corrupted game file. Once done, launch the game and check. Method 10. Update the graphics drivers. The next thing you should do is troubleshoot your graphics drivers. Right-click on the Windows Search button and choose Device Manager. Go to the Display Adapter section and then expand it. Right-click on your graphics driver. Select the Update Driver option. Click on the Search Automatically for Drivers option and follow the instructions provided on screen to download and install the latest driver. If updating graphics drivers doesn't work, you can reinstall them. Expand the Display Adapter section and right-click on your graphics driver. Click on the Uninstall Device option and follow the on-screen instructions to complete the process. After installation of the drivers, install them again. For the AMD graphics driver, install the Radeon app, then run it. Similarly, for NVIDIA graphics drivers, install and run the GeForce Experience. You should visit the official websites of your graphics card manufacturer to update your graphics card drivers. These websites are linked in the description below. Download the latest drivers for the graphics card installed on your computer from these websites. Follow the on-screen instructions to complete the driver installation process. Once done, restart your PC. Then rerun the app to check for any updates. If any updates are available, download and install them. Method 11. Run the game on a dedicated graphics card. If you have multiple GPUs for your system, then make sure to use the one for gaming as this can tackle the graphics intensive tasks well. So using the dedicated GPU for gaming can avoid issues while playing FC25. There are different ways to check if you are running the dedicated graphics card depending on your operating system and the specific card you have. You can follow the method shown here. Open Device Manager, expand Display Adapters. You should see two adapters listed here. One for your dedicated graphics card and one for your integrated graphics card. The dedicated graphics card will have a longer and more specific name than the integrated one. The dedicated graphics card may also have a higher memory size listed. So make sure to run the game with a higher memory size to avoid loading or crashing issues. Method 12. Install the proper version of DirectX. Many games, including FC25, require a specific version of DirectX to run properly. If you have an outdated or incompatible version, it will cause loading issues. The latest version of DirectX ensures the game's improved version. This is what you have to do to install DirectX. Search DirectX Runtime Download on Google and open the first result from Microsoft.com. Select the installer language you prefer and click on Download. Wait for the download to finish and then run the installer. Complete the installation and wait for the installation to finish. After the installation completes, restart your PC. Method 13. Install Visual C++ Redistributables. Installing Visual C++ Redistributable can be helpful since it includes a set of libraries that helps the game rely on and function normally. If these libraries are missing or outdated, it leads to starting issues. To install Visual C++ Redistributables, search for Visual C++ Redistributable in Google. Click on the first link of Microsoft.com. Download the recently available Visual C++ Redistributable. Ensure you download for the correct architecture like x64 for 64-bit systems and x86 for 32-bit systems. Install the downloaded file and restart your PC. Method 14. Close the apps running in the background. Sometimes the apps running in the background can interfere with your game and create problems. So before you start the game, close all the programs running in the background. Right-click on the Windows Start button and select Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab and right-click on the processes you want to close. Select the End Task option. Repeat the same for each task you want to kill. Then exit the window. And there you have it. The methods to fix ESports FC25 starting error. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.